It's like thunder and lightning. You heard me without trying. A tempestuous rising. No, I don't like to be this way. And you're Jekyll and hiding. Are you real?
Hi. We're Years and Years, and you can listen to all our music on YouTube Music. We made our own music video when we first started. We actually made our own first like two or three music videos. YouTube was just a really good way of reaching out to the fans. And
well, we didn't have any fans.
We didn't have any fans, but finding fans and finding our voice, really, I guess. You have to find your own space in music, and YouTube kind of helped us to do that, I think.
Yeah, I think we got a manager off the back of a video we put on YouTube. So it kind of was very instrumental in our beginnings.
Also tried to delete a video we did on YouTube, but it just seems to resurrect. It's like an undead. It's an undead video.
I guess for us, you know, Years and Years, the message is, well, I suppose I'm writing songs about my experience, like, living life and stuff, and all I'm trying to say is sometimes being in love is hard, sometimes being alive is hard, sometimes being gay in a world that maybe doesn't want you to be gay is hard, and like, just, you know, trying to speak my truth. And then you know, that always resonates with people, you know, because people are smart, they can understand when someone's, you know, being honest, I think. So that's kind of the message we're trying to send, is just encourage, you know, honesty and truth. Am I making sense?
Well, we have got, the three of us between us, cover a large swathe of music. Like, me and Mikey, we have like 90s rock in common, noughties rock in common, and then me and Ollie have like R&B and stuff like that in common. And I think, yeah, I mean, actually, I listen to a lot of interviews and stuff with musicians on YouTube, actually. That's what I do the most, but people I love and respect and stuff, so.
I just let the like video, everyone's music videos go like on loop, so I can see what everyone's doing, you know. So like, oh, how much budget did they have for their music video? How much money did they spend? Yeah, exactly. You know, so I can hit up the label for more money. So the music video is kind of, the process kind of, it can sometimes come from different places. Like sometimes when the song is finished, I'll just put it on my headphones and like dance around by myself until I like have this vision of what the music video should be. And then other times I'm like, oh, I really want to make a music video that's like about this particular story and this narrative. So for Palo Santo, it was like really important to me that there was a kind of like overarching narrative, and that the videos would kind of, you know, link up together. So that, and that took a long time of kind of planning and, you know, working with directors and, but for me, and I think for us, it's always been super important to make a statement visually. Because, you know, just because we have the opportunity, you know, so, you know, I want to make the most of it. Swipe up
to download
YouTube Music.